Hello viewers, today is 22nd September 2018 and today we are going to discuss a news which was published in the newspaper yesterday. I am talking about Times of India dated 21st September 2018. The news published was that a flight was going from Mumbai to Jaipur on 20th September 2018 early in the morning. This flight was in the air for some time and suddenly the people sitting in the cabin of the aircraft started bleeding in their nose and ears. There was a panic situation in the aircraft. This aircraft was landed in 45 minutes after the takeoff and the patients were taken to the hospital. Few were discharged after the treatment and the others who were in better condition were sent to Jaipur by an alternative aircraft. The reason which was published in the newspaper was that the crew member who were responsible for switching on the air conditioning system of the aircraft forgot to switch it on. I have picked up this news to understand what was the reason that this accident has occurred and what happens in our body when we move in an aircraft which is moving at a certain altitude. This is very unfortunate that this has happened with the people who are traveling in the aircraft, and we pray for their speedy recovery. As I told you that the staff forgot to switch on the air conditioning system of the aircraft, and this was the reason of this accident. So today we are discussing that why do we need air conditioning system in an aircraft. We all know that as we go up, the pressure and temperature of the air go down. We can experience this on mountains also. When we go to the mountains, the environment is quite cold and the pressure is also less because the density of the air is less. So there is less oxygen there, and generally when we move for a small distance, when we walk down a small distance, we feel tired. So this is because of the decrease in temperature and pressure of the air with altitude. So I have taken an example that at 10,000 meter height, the pressure of environment air is 0.15 bar and the temperature is minus 50 degrees Celsius. So when we talk about air conditioning system of a aeroplane, the first question comes in the mind is that when the temperature is so low, it is minus 50 degrees Celsius, why do we need a refrigeration or air conditioning system for an aircraft? So to understand this, first of all, we should understand that what happens in an aircraft when it moves in the air. When an aircraft is moving in the air, it is a confined volume in which the people are sitting, and there are a number of people sitting in the aircraft. When we are sitting idle, then our body discharges energy in the environment. And this energy is almost equal to 300 kilojoule per hour per person. Okay, this value may be different for different people, but we can consider this value as an average value. So this is 300 kilojoule per hour per person. So when the number of people are sitting in the aircraft, you can multiply the number of people into this value. So this much is energy accumulated in the aircraft because of the people sitting inside. Now there is another point, that is heat generation due to dissipation of fast moving air relative to aeroplane. When the aeroplane is moving in the air, there is a relative velocity of aeroplane with respect to the air, and because of this high velocity of the air, there is a term which comes in the picture, that is called skin friction. There is a skin friction between the aircraft and the air which is in contact of the outer surface of the aircraft, and because of this skin friction, there is a temperature gain in the outer surface of the aircraft. Once the outer surface of the aircraft becomes hot, then this heat is transferred to the cabin through conduction. So this is another cause of heat gain in the cabin of the aircraft. The next reason is medium size aeroplanes require 10 to 15 kilowatt energy for controlling devices. There are a number of electronic and electrical equipments in the aircraft which are used to control the aircraft, and these equipments run with energy only. So when they consume the energy, they discharge energy also, and this heat also causes the heat gain in the cabin of the aircraft. Next is direct solar radiation. There is a direct solar radiation on the aircraft which comes inside the cabin of the aircraft through the windows, and the outer surface of the aircraft is also exposed to the solar radiation. So this outer surface becomes hot, and as I told you that this hot surface transfers heat to the cabin through conduction. So these are the different reasons that cause heat gain in the cabin of the aircraft. So an air conditioning system is required to maintain the temperature of the aircraft at the comfort conditions. The comfort conditions at ground level are 22 degrees Celsius temperature and 1 bar pressure. This 1 bar pressure is equal to the atmospheric pressure. Okay, the average value of atmospheric pressure is 1 bar, and the normal temperature, which is called a comfort condition, is 22 degrees Celsius. So to maintain the cabin at 22 degrees Celsius and 1 bar pressure, an air conditioning system is required in the aircraft. So we can understand this, that if the temperature is not almost equal to 22 degrees Celsius, an air conditioning system is required. But why do we need to maintain the pressure in the aircraft? To understand this, we should know this fact, that when we are on the ground level, then our body is bearing the atmospheric pressure. There is atmospheric pressure around us, and this pressure, as I told you, is almost equal to 1 bar. So this pressure is consistently applied on us by the environment. And to sustain this pressure, there is an internal pressure of the body which balances this pressure. Okay, so what I am saying is that there is an internal pressure of the body which balances this outside pressure that is equal to 1 bar. So our body is habitual of balancing a pressure, balancing an outside pressure that is equal to 1 bar. So it means our body is also applying the same amount of pressure to balance this outside pressure that is equal to 1 bar. When we go up and we are sitting in the aircraft, as I told you that the pressure is very low, it may be 0.5 bar to 0.2 bar. So the outside pressure is low and the inside pressure is high. Because of this pressure difference, there will be expansion in the body. And because of this expansion of the body, we feel pain in the ear and our nose when we are moving the flight. And generally we observe this, that when the flight takes off, at that time there is we feel a pain in the ear and sometimes in the nose also. Generally, if you see if there are infants in the flight, they start crying. So the reason for our pain is the pressure difference and the expansion of our body because of this pressure difference. To adjust this pressure difference, we are given earbud or cotton to put in our ear so that we can balance this pressure difference. Now we have to understand, why does this happen when the flight takes off? Actually, at the time when the flight takes off, then the maximum power of the engine is utilized in giving thrust to the flight so that it can take off. And in that duration, the air conditioning system of the aircraft is cut off. Okay. Then the atmospheric pressure in the aircraft is lower than the internal pressure of the body. And that causes the expansion in the body. And that is why we feel pain in the air. Okay, and in extreme situations, there may be bleeding also. So the same thing happened in this aircraft, which we have just talked about. So as I told you, this was very unfortunate that this has happened with the people. And again, we pray for their speedy recovery and good health. So I hope you have understood that what was the main cause of this accident, and what happens in our body when the outside pressure and temperature are lower than the pressure of the body. So thank you so much. Keep watching, keep learning. Have a nice day.